next chapter of audiobook of How Life Works is Your Heart. How often we talk about your heart? We say someone has a big heart, a light heart, a heavy heart, a hard heart, a soft heart, a black heart, a change of heart, a broken heart, or no heart. And no one ever says, I love you with all my brain. Something else, when we point to ourselves, we never point our fingers at our head, we point to our heart. If feeling create our life experience, some logical question arise. Does the heart emit a strong energy? Do traditional cultures recognize heart or feeling energy? Is the heart more than just a pump? Can we measure energy from the heart? This is a question posed by a group of scientists at the Institute of Heart Math. Heart Math found that the heart produces by far the body's most powerful rhythmic electromagnetic field. This energy field is about 3 meters across and encircles your chest like a huge donut. This electromagnetic heart field is 5,000 times stronger than the field surrounding your brain. This is significant. Suddenly, the idea that how you feel shapes your destiny sounds a lot more reasonable. The next topic is a mystery. In the last 50 years, we have learned much about the brain, but less about the heart. We don't know what starts the heart beating in the womb, and we don't know why a heart can keep beating after it is disconnected from the brain. If you place a group of heart cells in a dish in a laboratory, with each of them separated, they will beat to a single rhythm. How do they do it? How do they know? The next topic is more mysteries. Paul Pearsall amassed 140 reports and audio tapes from patients who received other people's hearts. In his bestseller, The Heart's Code, he tells stories of patients who developed the behaviors and passion of their heart's donor. Before they knew anything about the donors, for example, a 35-year-old female recipient received the heart of a topless dancer. She reported that before the transplant, sex was not a big part of her life. After the operation, she explained, "I want sex every night. Now I tire my husband out. I used to hate X-rated videos. Now I love them. I think I got her sexual drive." A 52-year-old male who received the heart of a 17-year-old boy said, "I loved quite classical music before my new heart. Now I put on earphones, crank up the stereo and play loud rock and roll music." In her autobiography, A Change of Heart, Clara Sylvia tells of her own transformation. Before receiving a heart and lung transplant, she was conservative and health conscious. After a transplant, she developed a passion for beer, chicken nuggets, and motorbikes. When she spoke with the donor's family, she discovered that she had been given the heart of a beer-drinking, chicken-nugget-loving motorcyclist. Dr. Pearsall recounts the story of an 8-year-old girl who received the heart of a murdered 10-year-old girl. The 18-year-old began to have nightmares and reported that she knew the identity of the killer of her heart's donor. Police used descriptions and evidence provided by the 8-year-old to arrest the murderer, who was ultimately convicted. Reports Pearsall, the time, the weapon, the place, the cloth she wore, what the little girl he killed had said to him, everything the heart transplant recipient reported was completely accurate. How can this be? An emerging view is that all cells, not just brain cells, have memory. DNA code is contained in every cell of your body, so too, it seems, is memory. The Western concept is that the brain is king and the heart is a pump, but the heart has a nervous system of its own. The heart is a conscious organ. Your heart not only knows things, it remembers them. The next topic is what traditional cultures know. Traditional cultures know about life force or heart energy. There are over 100 words for it. The Polynesian call it mana. The Indians and Tibetan call it prana. The Iraqian call it origam. The Ituri call it Magbe. Chinese and Japanese medicine calls it Qi. Western medicine call it Baloney. In the West, we tend to worship the brain and ignore the heart. Western medicine has no words and no place for life force, prana or chi. And it is in the West that heart disease is out of the control, in nature trying to tell us something. In a nutshell, your feelings are not just incidental byproduct of your thoughts. Your feelings are your life force. They are your lifeline to the universe. Should this surprise us? The first organ to form in your mother's womb was your heart. Here we come to the end of this chapter. The next chapter of this book is We Are All Connected, and it is coming soon to you. Thank you.